Okay, so, okay, yes. So now we can start. And as I was telling, today we will talk about VOC, so volatile organic compounds. So compounds that are in gas phase. Okay. And in the previous webinar, we have talked a lot about dust filtration and oil mist filtration. So something that was in a phase of solid, like in the dust, like the case of the dust, and oil and liquid, like the case of the droplets regarding smoke or oil mist. Today, with the VOC, the meaning is volatile organic compounds, and so something that is in the in the gas phase. We can have several kinds of VOC. Just thinking about ethanol, methane, butanol, lots of other different compounds. So hydrocarbons, sulfuric compounds, ammonia compounds. So these compounds usually are toxic and can have some bad smell. So when do you use a VOC treatment? When you have this kind of compound in the air, you need to remove it because they are toxic. And today we will focus on the active carbon absorption. In general, in half filtration group, we have several ways to approach this kind of problem. And this is our concept. I mean, we want to solve the problem. And for solve the problem, we need several solutions, because not all the problems are equal. Not all the problems can be solved in the same way. So here you can see three methodologies, very different, because they can treat very different VOC compounds. The oxidation system, which is an RTO in this case, but is an oxidation system where you have the destruction, the oxidation of your pollutant, of your contaminant, of your VOC, and you have the conversion of it to carbon dioxide, so you have the destruction of the VOC. Then you can have a washing tower. So in the case that you have a VOC that is very soluble in water or soluble in a certain amount, you can treat this kind of VOC with such a system. So you have air with your VOC, you put water in this tower, encounter current, and you have the solubilization of the VOC in water. So you change the phase of the VOC. Of course, in this case, you need a VOC that is soluble. Another application is instead the active carbon. So today we will talk about the active carbon technology. And in the webinar of next week, we will talk about the scrubber, the washing tower technology. And the week after, we will talk about RTO oxidation systems. So which is the concept of the active carbon adsorption? So basically, you have your compound in the gas phase. You have the active carbon, which is solid, and we will see some examples and we will go deeply on this. But you have a solid and you have the gas molecule that absorb, that is captured by the particle, the solid particle. And so in this case, you don't have a destruction, but you have a separation. So you have your VOC that goes on the surface of the carbon. This is the concept. Which are the applications? As you can imagine, we can find VOC application in, of course, in painting industry, coating industry, plastic industry, where we have the use of solvent and we have vapors. or in the case where we have a bad smell, in every case that we have a bad smell, for example, I'm thinking about all the techniques that use oil, machine tools and so on. In that case, in addition to the problem of oil mist, you can have also the problem of bad smell, and you need to treat this kind of bad smell. So I'm just starting to give you the idea that all the filtration techniques can be combined, and the expertise that we have in one sector, we can bring this expertise in another sector. For example, in the case of oil mist, or in the case of VOC, or changing the type of industry. So I told you that those examples, but I can tell you automotive application in the food industry. Just try to imagine all the bad smell that you have in the food industries. And this is the general overview of the application. And now we will go deeply on the active carbon technology. So please, Daniele, if you can help me. Thanks a lot. So this is a PC carb. PC carb is an active carbon filter. We have two main families of active carbon filters. The PC carb, which is a product that is suitable for application where we don't need to achieve a very high limits, a very high result. Because just imagine, we have situation where you need, from a legislative point of view, to achieve some limit. And so we need to proper size the bed. And in that case, we use some active carbon, but with a customized design. And there are other cases where we can use PC carb. And PC carb is a good technology also to be combined to other techniques, because you can see it is modulable. I mean, you can have several modules of this kind of PC carb. You can have the PC carb with a separate ventilator and so on. So let's go inside this kind of filtration system. This is an example of carbon. You see, the dimension of this carbon is can be 3 millimeter, 4 millimeter, depending. And which kind of carbon do we use? Usually, it strongly depends on which kind of VOC we have, because not all the carbon is the same. I cannot use the same carbon, the general purpose carbon, for everything. For some application, of course, but not for everything. And this is also our approach. We approach the problem not just to putting a general purpose carbon, but also focusing on which kind of VOC we have and how can we treat with the best active carbon. So I showed you an application of, an example of active carbon, but let's go inside. So here we have, in the structure of this filter is similar, very similar to the cartridge filters that we have in the Pulsatron set. So we have the inlet of the air polluted stream in the backside. Below, we can have a drawings or something as a pre-filtration stage. And we will go deeper later about why we need a pre-filtration stage for the dust. We will talk later. But for now, let's focus here inside. So we have several cassettes of active carbon, filled with active carbon. So this system can contain 120 kilogram, 130 of active carbon. But the concept of this filter is that we wanted, with the, our R&D department, we wanted to optimize the maintenance, because usually the problem of active carbon are when you need to do the maintenance. And we and for us, this was the critical point. So as you can see here, you can remove with handles, and in the best way, the operator can remove the cassette. Here you can see an example of cassette. So you have this filter, this cassette, sorry, full of carbon. And he can, the operator can clean the cassette in an easy way. And this was our main goal in the designing of this kind of car, of this kind of PC car. Because that is the critical point. After this, we have the fan, the ventilator, and we have the aspiration. We can put the ventilator on the ground if we need to achieve a very high pressure drop and so on. So all the technical things that we have developed for the dust filtration is the same here in the VOC. And this is the concept. I mean, we need, if you want to approach filtration system, you need to consider all the things. Also in this case, we supply carbon, and we have this kind of system, but we design also the captation, the sanction system, and so on, which is fundamental in order to optimize the VOC concentration and the VOC treatment. So this is basically the structure, and is a basic system, because case by case we can add several options. For example, if we have a problem with the temperature, we can install some temperature sensor in order to detect the temperature. Why the temperature is important in the case of active carbon? Temperature is important because if you increase the temperature, you decrease the efficiency of filtration. Why? Because I told you that we have an active carbon particle, and we have the VOC, and we have that the VOC is absorbed on the particle. But if I increase the temperature, I increase, let me say, the will of this particle to not be attached. I decrease the energy that there is between the particle and the VOC. And so I have a low efficiency of the process. And this is critical because there are some applications where the customer has 30 degrees, and after that they change some working procedure, and they have an increase of the temperature, and they see that the efficiency of the filter is strongly reduced. This is because active carbon is strongly dependent on temperature. The same thing is regarding the moisture, the humidity, the water level in the air. If we have an increasing of water in the air, of humidity, we have that this water compete to the absorption with the VOC. And so we have an absorption of the humidity instead of the VOC. And this is a problem because we deactivate the carbon sooner than in the case of just dry VOC. So also humidity is critical. And sometimes if we have humidity higher than 80% of relative humidity, we cannot apply carbon, because otherwise we have the clocking also of the carbon beds, and we have problem in the filtration. So like every case, these systems are simple if we focus on them, managing all the variables and all the things that, that can influence the filtration stage. Another example is that if we have the presence of very of VOC that are very flammable, that can be generate flame with fire with the carbon, then we need to use some systems that prevent this. For example, we have applied some system where when we have the VOC inside, we maintain the flow. But otherwise, if the production is stopped, we need to maintain the bed with a flowing of air in order to prevent this kind of fire accident, let me say. This is just for a critical application, of course, like in the case of methyl ethyl ketone, which is a MEK abbreviation. But this is an example. Not always, but sometimes must be checked these things. And so I give you an overview regarding this application. As I told you, this is a PC carb, is a small configuration. We can have several modules, several PC carb combined. Okay, if we have an increased flow rate. But if we need to achieve very critical limits and strictly limits, we need to proper design the bed in another way. Because here you see, I mean, when we design an active carbon bed, we consider the flow rate, the section, the area of the bed, and the height of the bed, because we need to maintain a certain velocity and the residence time inside the active carbon bed. And as you can imagine, here we have a certain time, residence time, and a certain velocity. But if we need to achieve proper efficiency, this could be not enough. Sometimes it's enough, and we have applied it, but sometimes no. So it is important to approach these kind of issues, like in the case of dust, like in the case of oil mist, always considering all the parameters and a global overview, not just considering these like a system without example, for example, considering the sanction system. Because also, just to give you an idea, the amount of carbon that we have here strongly influences the pressure drop that we have on the ventilator, on the fan. And so we need to proper see the overview and help and supply our customers and partners with this kind of information. So I think we can have time now for some questions. Like the other webinars, you can ask, you can type on the chat in order to not overcome voices and not have a conflict of people that talk. Martina will help me in the question, and so we can go on. Martina?
Hi, Matteo. So as usual, we will wait for your questions. And in the meantime, we will go through some of the most frequently asked questions. Like, for instance, how often is it necessary to change the activated carbon?
Yeah, thanks, Martina. This is critical because, and it is something that theoretically, if we know the amount of VOC that is coming inside, we know a certain value. And we know, for example, I have 2 kilogram per hour of ethanol that are coming inside the filter. I know the amount of carbon that I put inside. And if I know that, I don't know, the efficiency of the carbon selected for this application is 40%, let me say, we can have a running time of, I don't know, 600 hours, 1,200 hours, and so on. So theoretically can be estimated. But if we have a problem of bad smells, of bad odors, and we don't know exactly the concentration or similar, in that case, and we don't have analysis, in that case, theoretically cannot be assessed. So what we do now in this case is to share with our customers and partners our experience. So sometimes it happens that we know that for a specific application, a PC carb with 50 kilograms can last 6 months, for example. But it is important always to say these things, because otherwise it looks that we are not considering these things. So the answer is depends, but using theory, and so the science theoretically and our expertise, we can give you an answer.
Okay, very clear. So which is the airflow for each modular filter?
Okay. Also, this depends on the amount of carbon that we put inside. Usually for the PC carb, we can have for this module, 2000 cubic meter per hour. But of course, it strongly depends of how much VOC we have. You know, in this field, it is fundamental to understand the concentration that we have. Because sometimes there are concentration that are too high, and we are the first that we say to the customer, look, you have a concentration of VOC too high, and so if you want an active carbon, you will have a lifetime of just 20 days. But other times, no. The important is the approach, and we want to maintain this approach to our customers.
Okay, so which is the most common industry that uses activated carbon filters?
In terms of industries, we are very broad. Everywhere that you have, for food industries, automotive, but we are applying a lot in the plastic industries, painting industries. For example, we have application also where we have, as I was telling you, oil mist, but also bad smell. And so we put a mist compact or MCOS coupled with PC carb. And you see the structure and everything is made in order to have the best combination of the two filters. Or for instance, we have applied this in the filtration of dust. So there are applications where you have dust, but also you use some paintings combined. And in that case, you can use a pulsatron and then a PC carb. And then we have several other applications, all the tank storage where they have a bad smell coming from the tanks, or gasoline sector. Active carbon is one of the most flexible technologies because it can be applied everywhere. But proper of this thing, it is very flexible, but must be properly selected. So it is easy to apply, but its application needs to focus properly on the problem, because not always can be applied active carb.
Okay, so the next question regards the maintenance. Is it possible to only change the carbon, the activated carbon inside the cassette, the drawer, or is it necessary to change the whole thing, so the whole drawer?
Oh yeah, exactly. Thanks for the question, because this is critical. We designed the system in order to be very easy for the maintenance, because in this case, as you have seen, the pellets of carbon are 3-4 millimeters, but there is lots of dust due to the mechanical stress, the mechanical destruction of this kind of pellet. So in this way, the operator must just be remove the drawings, remove the upper side, pour the carbon in a tank and fill with another carbon. So another point can be, and I want to connect to your question on this point, what I can do with the spent carbon, with the exhaust carbon. So the exhaust carbon can be regenerated, but this is strongly dependent of which kind of VOC it was absorbed. Sometimes can be regenerated, and there are companies that regenerate the carbon, but other times, no. The carbon is completely deactivated, and you need to fill with a new one.
Okay, and what about the filtration of solvent-based products with our PC carb?
Yeah, exactly. Solvent-based product is one of the most suitable application. The point is always to understand the concentration inlet, because if I have a very concentrated stream of VOC, this carbon can last only 20 days, 30 days. And this is also why our approach is always to understanding the problem and try to find a solution. Because, just to give you an idea, considering this product or an oxidizer, we have a different capital investment, a very different. But what we do usually is also to do a calculation of the carbon expenditure, the running cost of the active carbon installation and the running cost of the oxidation system. And sometimes you can find that the capital investment of an oxidation is higher in the beginning, but you can recover it and you have a break-even point in 1 year. Other times, no. Otherwise, is from our side that we suggest active carbon because the concentration is suitable for active carbon.
Okay, so let's suppose we are working in an environment where there is a strong humidity. So is humidity a problem? Can it affect the performances of the activated carbon or the life of the activated carbon?
Yes, as said before, it strongly affects the life. And usually, just to give you an idea, if we have 60-70% of relative humidity, it is okay. But the problem is where we have a higher amount of humidity. And so these are some values that, of course, depend case by case. But to give you an idea, yes, if, for example, I have a washing tower and I have lots of humidity, very 100% of humidity, I cannot put an active carbon. And there are people, there is some people who try to apply these on very high humidity application and doesn't work. And this is properly because we have a very high level of humidity, which is in competition with the VOC for absorption. And also we have the clogging of the bed because we have the condensation of the water.
Okay, so for the moment, we don't have any more questions. So thank you, Matteo. I think that's it.
Yeah, thanks, Martina. Just to clarify, for every information, further information that you need, we are here, open to answer your questions, also, of course, also personally in private. But the message is that our approach is still the same, also with this kind of application. Like in the dust, like in the oil, like we can do the same in the VOC, because this is our approach. So thanks, thanks to everyone. And I hope that you will follow also the webinar of next week for the scrub and the week after of the oxidation system. For now, everything. So have a good day. Proud to be HF.